All right. I want to know what's up with Daisy. What's going on? New hair, new eyeliner, new hats.
I know. It's dark. It's like dramatic. She's in a darker place. She's mourning. She cares for the team so much that she feels like she is protecting them by kind of pushing them away, because like, she feels like everything bad happens around her. She can't help but cause problems. I think her way of taking care of the people she cares about is kind of pushing them away, which doesn't necessarily is the best thing. Don't think it's going to last long term. But we see a darker. She's really sad. She's really sad.
With Ghostwriter coming, and we've heard that there's a lot of threat and could be very dangerous, and so I think that she is very cautious and kind of want to get that contained. So yeah, I don't think she's not.
It's gonna probably. I want to see, because all of the kind of crazy powers, and it's all kind of been rooted in science. And something that Simmons and FitzSimmons can always explain why it's happening.
Right.
So I'm curious to see how the writers are gonna write it for your character to explain how he could possibly have his skull be lit on fire and then be fine.
Yeah.
So here's where they go with it.
Right,
yeah. Was this for us?
Oh, yeah. This is
vodka.
Because we saw an entirely new movie in that fashion. Are we going to see anything else more?
I think it'll be a lot more of that thing. The whole flyy, I don't know what's happening.
Flopping.
Super like badass flopping. But the, as I said before, you know, we don't, I'm not being monitored by S.H.I.E.L.D. every step of the way, you know, through my transformation as an inhuman. It's been monitored by FitzSimmons and kind of containing and helping me grow my powers. And so I think you'll see the repercussions of her kind of using these new powers and abusing them in a way, kind of abusing her body. And so physically she's in not great shape when we first see this episode. She's not going to be doing well because she's not with Simmons.
We didn't get to see Simmons in the finale. But could you tell us a little bit about where she's at, where she's going to pick up at the 6 months later point?
I mean, the teaser at the end, we saw Red Dead, you know, potentially talking to a life model decoy. So that's something that, you know, she would be very interested in, and is kind of in her and Vince's realm. And so that's going to play a part in this season for her.
What about the FitzSimmons relationship? Where do you want that to go?
Oh, honestly, I'd just like them to be happy and fine for a bit. But we'll see. I mean, this is the first time they've been in a relationship romantically, and they've been on holiday together, and with everything that's happened, you know, in the finale of the episode, they finally got together, and then just everything went down. They lost friends, and, you know, Hyde died, but also Ward finally died, and we lost him for the last time, and any chance of redemption, you know, was gone, and so I think that was just so much for them to deal with, that now they're just trying to concentrate on being a romantic couple, and also trying to navigate those waters, because if you've ever been in a relationship, you know that it's not easy,
especially at work.
Agree. At work.
Like we live at work.
Very close. Yeah. So, it's a kind of a fun dynamic we're going to get to see.
I feel like it's how that happens.
Babies would be fine.
They'd be the cutest. Fitz would be such a good dad. Right?
Yeah, I think Ian would. Fitz would be too.
Do you see actually any of the people that I said I've been with them for 4 years, and they said that they are a lot like Fitz? Do you see any of their relationship, more to a relationship with Fitz?
relationship because, I mean, Marissa and Jen have the best relationship ever. So I think that, like, a lot, I mean,
I think their friendship is similar.
You see a lot of their personalities in them for sure, and their isms and kind of how they play off each other. I think they definitely put that in the writing for FitzSimmons. They're a lot more solid than FitzSimmons in terms of, like, knowing what they want. But definitely the bond is the same. And I mean, I think we all get so much inspiration from Marissa and Jed on a very personal level and then on a professional level. They're just wonderful and so creative and, like, financially minded to be able to run a show, but then so personable and, you know, care about all of us and are just the best people to work for.
They really are, and their writing is so easy. You know, it's I can always tell when something was written by them in particular because they just know our dialogue so much, their personalities are really in there, and they know. You know, we've really grown together as a family on the show, and like at the panel, we saw our audition tapes, and it's so crazy to see how far all of our characters have gone and how far away my long hair has gone.
Love this happening.
Thank you.